we know all the law of Ukraine, how she can get out, what she needs. It's much easier for us to set up the date and to help her with her logistics than you trying to help her to get out from Donetsk.
Plus, if you don't meet, then there's no charge at all. I am non-religious. I know most of the Ukrainian women are going to be very religious. Well, that's a premise that I want Anna to address, but we'll get to that in a second. I am certainly not going to stand in the way of someone's religious beliefs. My question is, would that be a good combination, or would that not be? Thanks, so sorry I cannot meet you in Las Vegas. Will the seminar come to the Bay Area again? Yeah, we're going to be doing seminars in the Bay Area again. And in Southern California and all around. We're gonna get those going again. But Anna, why don't you address his questions about, first of all, are the women super religious in Ukraine?
No, they are not.
Okay, well, that's one thing. So that's kind of you got to watch your premises there because, yeah, I don't think so either. I mean, they're Orthodox.
We are Orthodox, but we are not crazy religious, first of all, because during the USSR, they didn't let us to be religious, so they closed the churches. Instead of the churches, they did actually nightclubs, and I know a few places like that.
Or produce factories, in Russia.
So they are not really religious. We are believing, you know, we believe in God, and yes, I go to church twice a year, on Christmas and on Easter. That's it. So I don't know what is percent of religious girl, but yeah, most of them are not religious.
And also, Eric, what I would tell you is that no matter who you end up marrying, whether it's here, there, or Mars, you always want to be respectful of the other person's wants and desires, right? And she comes over and she really is religious and she wants to go to church and she wants to do the things that make her happy, then at the very least, you would respect that, I would think, and let her do that, or give her her space to do that. And even maybe support her by going with her and joining her and showing her that you care about her, so you're willing to do that. That's what makes a marriage really nice, is when you can do those things for each other, even if you're really not so much into it as the other person is, but if you actually support that person and what they're doing, then they're going to support you more in what you want to do, and yes, that's how you continue to build a marriage.
Yes, you know, you might go to a shooting range and she's not going to be about shooting, she's not going to like to kill animals or just to go to shooting range at all, but I'm sure she's going to support you and she will go with you there twice a year, three times a year. So I think that you can support her in that as well, if she will decide to go to church twice a year.
I've been communicating with someone for several months now and I'm trying to set up a meeting. She's coming from Donetsk, so it's complicated. It's getting her email still another 400 plus. Well, what I would suggest really is, instead of doing that, is just letting us help you to set up the date.
Yes.
You need to call Anna and help set it up, right? Because if we can do that, then it's about half that cost and we can help you actually set up the date. So she's coming from Donetsk and she wants to meet you in Poland or someplace. We'll do all the arrangements.
We will help her with logistics actually.
Yeah.
Because we know all the trains, how it go. You know, we have managers from Kiev office that usually travels a lot to Poland and back. We know all the law of Ukraine, how she can get out, what she needs. It's much easier for us to set up the date and to help her with her logistics than you trying to help her to get out from Donetsk.
Plus, if you don't meet, then there's no charge at all. If you get her, you know, the address and everything, yeah, there's gonna be a charge. And then if you don't meet or something happens, you still have that information that we gave you. You're not gonna be a refund. So you're much better off doing that and dealing with her and letting us help you arrange to meet. It's safer for her, safer for you. It ensures that you're gonna meet her and we help the process. That's what we do. We help facilitate that. So it's a way better way to go. And there's a lot of reasons for that too. And if you want to call and talk to me or Anna, who does a lot of these, she's in charge of all the independent introductions, she can tell you a lot of reasons why this works really well this way and why we do what we do.
join men from all over the world as they take a trip and find their future brides. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Then click on the notice bell to get notified every time we add something new. Interested? Learn more at poltavawomen.com.